Hey, happy birthday. I made you something. Today, I'm going to show you how you can customize this starting soon screen template that I made for you. It's going to be a PSD file that you can download at gumroad.com/getlevel. But if you don't own Photoshop, you can also modify it. I will show you how to do that too. You'll be able to change the text, the color, and most importantly, you're not going to have my face on your starting soon screen. So I'm going to show you how to add your own picture into the screen. All of that with just a couple of clicks. But right before that, a quick message from our sponsor. Hey you, are you looking for emotes? Then you need to check out Own's Emote Maker. Check this out. In a couple of clicks, I create one character and then Own generates the rest. All you gotta do is go to own.gg/getlevel, hover over sub emote in badges and click Emote Maker. So try it out. That is own3d.gg/getlevel. Okay, of course this is a starting soon screen, but if you change the text, it's a whatever screen. It can be a BR back screen, it can be a stream ending screen. I was thinking about how almost everyone is using a pre-made one from so many websites, including gumroad.com/getlevel. But even those who have their custom ones, they often lack what is the most important, the real thing that's gonna make it particular, that's gonna make it special. And nothing is more special than you. That's not what I meant. What I mean is there's nothing more original, there's nothing more personal than a picture of you. So a big thing here that I want to tell you is that if you are looking for more templates of that sort, stuff that you can actually customize, not really pre-made, you can really add your own sauce to it without any effort, you'd probably go to placeit.net. You would type something like intermission screen or starting soon, for example. Let's see what's up. Starting soon, there's 156 templates, and you would just click on one and then customize it. That one looks cool. Let's click on it. Didn't even realize this was animated. Look at that. So you see the text, all of the text here, you can actually customize it. You can customize the pictures that show, you can put your own video. Top right, you will see there's actually the track playing. So you can completely create your stream intro with this. Let me put like Get Level, for example, instead of DJ Astro, whatever. It's gonna load the preview. So it's gonna preview the last changes, and I'm going to, actually, let me also change the color to purple. And let's upload an image. So here, upload image or video. Yeah, you can actually crop it if you want. And boom, it's showing me the last changes. And if I click here and update slide, look at that, look at that. Couple clicks. Of course, if you don't have a picture of you or whatever, there's a whole library on the website. Like, there's a ton of pictures. Some of them might be even related to the game that you're playing. So check it out. It's placeit.net. I will have a link in the description. Placeit.net is not free, but with my link in the description, you're actually getting 15% off. So check it out. So here I am in Photoshop, and this is what the starting soon screen is gonna look like. Now, the first thing that I want to address really fast before you click off the video is that you can change the color. It doesn't have to be purple. It's the first comment that I'm gonna get is, well, I wish it was blue. Well, it can be blue. Boom, now it's blue. What are you gonna say now, huh? Oh, I wish it was red. Let me click on the color here, double click on the color here and make it red. Actually, you can make it whatever color you want. Boom, it's red, it's saturated red. It's less saturated red. It's black and white. You decide. The very first step that you need to do before downloading it is actually reading the product description. Every time I put a product up on Gumroad, you need to read the product description before downloading it. You never know. Maybe I say that, oh, if you don't download this, you agree to sell me your soul. And boom, you sold me your soul. It's in the description. You didn't read? Too bad for you. Read the product description. You're an adult. You're a responsible adult. A lot of underage people gonna download this. Anyways, in the product description, you will find a link to the font that I'm using here, which is, I forgot what it was, Dry Brush. And the link will bring you right here to the font that I actually use. So what you need to do is click download. It's gonna say download for you, probably. Download, and it's gonna be a zip file, and then you're gonna have to unzip it and install it. I'm not gonna teach you how to install a font. Go on Google, type how to install a font. Once the font is installed, only when it's installed, you can open up your PSD file, either in Photoshop or online for free on PHOTOPEA.com or PHOTOPEA.com. I will show you how to customize it later on PHOTOPEA, okay? So right now, Photoshop users, this is what you need to do. You open it up, this is what it says, right? So your font is installed, so it's gonna recognize it automatically. Super cool. You can click You can double click on the T where it says starting soon. I put it in blue here so you can recognize what it is. You can double click on the T and then type whatever you want. Okay, so whatever language you speak, it's not bound to any language. You can put whatever language you want. If you wanted to say be right back or ending screen, you can make those intermissions too. Now, you will see that there's a part that says open here. It's like the little orange part, okay? Let me collapse that. It's gonna say open here. You open it and then you're gonna see place photo in a group, okay? That's a group. So what you're gonna do is find any picture that you have, okay? Preferably one that kind of resembles, you know, that one that I have here, but that's besides the point. Let's find a random picture. So I'm gonna click on the group here and then I'm gonna grab a picture and I'm gonna just drag and drop it. Okay, now it didn't place it where I wanted it to be, but that's fine. I'm just gonna put it over there and I'm gonna drag and drop it inside where it says place photo. Boom, and now it's being affected by the mask of this group, okay? The group that says place photo. So I'm gonna press Control T in order to resize it to make it fit. Let me zoom out a little bit and I'm just gonna drag the corners until I feel like it fits the whole, you know, the brush aspect. There you go. Something like that. Don't be scared, make it big. And boom, there it is. My picture fits. Random picture, it works. If I want to activate like the colors, you'll see this says photo color and then black and white. You can put it black and white first and then add this color on top of it. Don't change this color, okay? Photo color, don't change it. Color up top is an adjustment layer. You see that little circle next to it? So you activate it. It's probably gonna change color already. You can double click here in order to bring up the hue and saturation. And then you can just change it to whatever color you want, okay? Any color you want. You can play with saturation, the lightness, but mostly the hue, okay? Let's put it to blue, because apparently you guys love blue. And if I turn it off, I'm gonna have the purple. And if I turn this off, I'm gonna have like the skin tone. But it's better if you have like that color, okay? Now, another part of this whole thing is the socials, right? It says Twitter, it says Instagram, even though that's not even Instagram, that's like the YouTube logo. I also added the Instagram logo. So if you open this up, you will see socials. Let me put that back. You will see that under social, there's the text, right? There's the Instagram text, there's the Twitter text. Again, you can type whatever you want, whatever you need. Twitter, same thing. And then there's the YouTube logo, which you can turn off and replace by the Instagram logo, for example, right? I added those icons in the pack so that you can play around with them. If you want to add your own icon, do whatever you want, okay? Just do whatever you want. Apparently, you're a pro at Photoshop. You got this. I believe in you, okay? And that's pretty much it. Now, don't go thinking that you have access to every single thing. In order to make this product free, I had to basically merge a lot of layers. I'm talking to the Photoshop experts here. I had to merge a lot of layers, so you don't have a lot of, you know, free range when it comes to modifying or displacing certain things, but you know, you can replace the background if you want. You can change the color of the background if you want, and all of that. You can change the text, of course, you can change the colors, you can change the font. All of that is still available, okay? But this is all mostly made for you to place your picture in there. It can be a picture of your logo too. Change the text, especially for the socials, and then export, right? Okay, now let's show you how to do it in a free software and for people who don't have Photoshop. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this picture. So I would go and type PHOTOPEA, or PHOTOPEA, as I like to call it, .com. I'm gonna click open from computer, okay? And then you will find the one file, the one PSD file that you have, and it will open up as if it was Photoshop. Isn't that great? Isn't that amazing? Now here's the problem. Right now the font is showing up perfectly, but it's not installed on PHOTOPEA. So you're gonna click on the text tool, that's the T on the left side, and then under font, you will click load font, all right? In the font file that you downloaded, remember that was step one, you're gonna go and find it. In my case, it was called Drybrush, right? Drybrush TTF right here. And I'm gonna click open. And now it's gonna ask you, do you want to load this also next time you use the editor? And I'm gonna click okay. You never know. Maybe I wanna go back and do something about this, right? And now, if you wanna modify the text, double click on the T and type whatever you want. The effects are already applied and everything, right? Same thing for Twitter and Instagram. They're all here. The exact same thing that I just showed on Photoshop. Instagram and Twitter, you have the icon here. If you want to replace it with YouTube, for example, it's right there. If you want to place your photo, it's going to be in that group. So let's go ahead and find a photo and then place it in there. Let's find a different picture, for example, right? Let's find this picture and let's just place it, right? Now it actually put it in the group because that's how you do it. And I'm just going to place it and then I'm going to modify it so that it fits. I'm gonna hold shift to maintain the proportions. And here I am. Here I am. Press enter. Boom. You just did it. Oh, remember the color? All the way to the top. Boom. Now it's blue. Double click on whatever that is, the hue swatch, and make it any color that you want. Yeah, but Gil, what do I do when I'm done? You just exported. File. Export as PNG, click save, type whatever you want, save, boom, and then just add it to your broadcasting software. Easy clap. But how do I add it to my broadcast? Come on now, add source image, and then that's it, and then find the file. That's it. And that's pretty much all you need to know. It's going to be available at gumroad.com/gallevel. Once again, read the product description if you have any questions about it. Also read the product descriptions because it tells you where to ask your questions, and where to ask your question is my Discord channel, which will be linked in the description of this video, but also in the product description. If you would like to see like a step-by-step of like how I made this, just let me know in the comments. I figured like you guys might not be that interested. This is why I put it like in a time lapse, but yeah. I might start doing those also live on my Twitch channel. So go check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/gallevel. And if you want to talk to me and interact with me, this is the best place to go. Another thing is that I currently have some sort of a giveaway going on. It's not really a giveaway because it's not random. Basically, I announced on Twitter, to give you a reason to follow me there, that I was going to pick someone and then revamp their whole Twitch channel for free. All they had to do is drop their links and a brief description of their Twitch channel in the comments of said tweet. I'll let you go to my Twitter and find out. Top right, YouTube will tell you which video you should watch next. Bottom of it, you will see my most recent video. So go ahead and keep on learning about live streaming and graphic design and all that cool stuff. I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.